When the baton got passed from Jim to Gilly, he knew, Mike Gilligan knew, what was being passed to him. And I don't think he ever, even if he is God, which he will claim, of course, but even if he is God, gods can be humble. And I think coaching the same number of years that Jim did, with one fewer victory, is either a great credit to Gilly or a great credit to the hockey gods who made it that way. Because I think Gilly's much happier that it ended that way than having one more than Jim. Please welcome my brother.
Testing that victory. I hope we all understand how lucky we are to have Gary here tonight. He's one of the top announcers in all sports, and one of my very favorites, and one guy that knows hockey and he knows our history. So, Gary, thank you so much for helping us tonight. One note to Toby. Toby, if you'd like to have my seat in heaven, I'll take those jerseys a little bit early. as was stated, a big thank you to Ned, Krista, and Catherine for all they've done tonight. It was just fabulous, but it was a lot of fun working with them, working with the committee. The committee was just great, getting a hold of all of you guys. You've seen some of the video. Some of the guys in the video were a little fancier off the ice than on over the past several years, but they were all pretty good. It was amazing. For 19 years, Cross had three skilled guys in his program. I heard that, but you know, before the 50th year team, there were a bunch of guys that played hockey here that played real good hockey, and they were here before that 50-year. Mark, and there's a couple of people here that played in the 50s. They graduated in the 50s, actually. The guys played outdoors. We have some pictures scattered around the Patrick Gym of guys that played Clarkson in 1948, 1949. And there's a couple of people here before that anniversary began. And I don't know if John is here, but there's a few guys that played before that 63 cutoff, and I'd love them to stand up and take a round of applause. An awful lot to you. They come back for alumni games all the time. It means an awful lot to us, and it's all about the people, and that's where the hockey began. It just didn't begin 50 years ago. It began with a lot of people. Denny Lambert used to say to me that John Donnelly had an awful lot. He came from Hamden, Connecticut. He was a football guy by trade, a great golfer, but he had a lot to do with putting that facility together. So there were a lot of guys that were in the foundation of this program. There's a couple of very important people I have here with me tonight, and I just wanted to mention a few. At my table, I've got the guy that hired me, Denny Lambert. He was a football coach here. He was obviously a student athlete here, and just a great human being. I don't know if he was too smart putting me on, but he did. And interesting, and I owe Denny an awful lot for hiring me and giving me the opportunity. I came from Yale University after 3 years at Yale. I was the interim head coach for 1 year, and Tim Taylor was coming back from the Olympics, and I was going to have to go back to an assistant's position. Jimmy Cross told me he was getting out, and I became very interested. So, Denny, thank you so much for that chance. One interesting story about Denny, my third year, I think we went to the Garden and we beat Harvard. I think Sneddon was on the team. So we went to the championship game, so I thought I was pretty good at what I did. I came back and I went into Denny's office. I said, Denny, I'm making about $38,000 a year. Everybody else is making a lot more. I talked to him at the convention. He said, "What did you say?" I said, "Geez, I'd like just a little bit more money." And Denny said, "Last year when you won 4 games, I didn't come up your office and take money back from you." Anyway, Denny, thank you so much, and it's great to have you here tonight. Another great guy that was Denny's assistant that took over when Denny retired is Rick Farnham, a real good friend of mine. Stood through some really great seasons for us, signed a lot of your scholarship letters and carried a lot of your applications to admissions, and then became the athletic director and fought for us and was just super and very supportive in a couple of tough instances that we had. Had a lot more good fun with Rick than bad. I'll tell you, he's quite a guy and a guy that stands up behind you. Rick, thank you so much. And lastly, Bob Corin, who was my present supervisor and athletic director. He gave me the chance to stick around and to become meaningful to the school and the department. He's used me in lots of different roles, and I've had an absolute joy working with different teams and getting to know the community even better. Bob, thanks so much for finding a place for me. When I showed up for the job, I stood around the watched captain's practice, and I saw the guys moving around. I'm standing beside this couple of guys, and one of them was in the stands at the time. And I said to Kevin Foster, "Who's that guy?" He says, "That's Mac." I said, "Who the hell's Mac?" And he said, Mac's with the team. He's a guy that used to follow the team around to all the away games." And Jimmy Cross says, "Hey, Mac, if you're going to be doing that, why don't you get on the bus? It's dangerous out there." Mac became a really important person and became actually our equipment guy for years. He became a great friend of mine, a good fishing buddy. And Mac passed away recently. And we certainly miss him. He dedicated most of his life to UVM hockey. He was a great and trusted friend. And I know a lot of you guys have missed him. I have with us tonight his bride, Abigail McIntosh. Calling me up and saying, "What the hell do you mean by this?" I've also got some guys out there that started coaching with me. There's a bunch that couldn't make it tonight, but some guys that showed up that are great guys, started their coaching careers here after playing. A couple of them didn't play here, but they certainly coached for us and have gone on. Please recognize and stand up Billy Kangas, Joe Gervais, Damian DeJulian, Terry Lovelett, and Greg Spitz. Thanks, guys. Lifelong sports informations guy, a guy that just has won so many awards with his writings, a personal friend of mine and a great guy, even though we didn't leave him at Princeton one night. somebody said, "Coach, there's an extra sub." I said, "Oh, it's amazing." He said, "Should I split it?" I said, "Yeah, split it." Okay. Got him back up to Yale. From the sports info department, a great guy, Dick Whittier. Please stand up, Dick. And of course, the people that succeeded Wick, we've got Gordon Woodworth and Maria McClellan. Thanks, guys, for coming. Guys are recruiting some of the young ladies for the hockey program, and I worked with them for 6 years. It was just great to be able to say to the kids, hey, you've got some Zamboni guys that if you come in, the icer, just tell them you'd like some ice. They'd make it. They keep it for you. They're just tremendous guys. They're hard workers. They're dependable. They're trustworthy. We've got a table full of our Zamboni guys. Please stand up. UVM is not just about hockey. It's about everybody out here. It's about people. It's about family. It's about relationships. It's about the Mac McIntoshes, those experiences. It's about being invited to Bill and Sue Spence's to get to meet some of you Jim Cross alums. They opened up their home to me my first year to come down to Massachusetts and to meet some of the guys that Jimmy coached. The guys were so welcoming. It was a pleasure to succeed Jim. It was an honor to succeed Jim, but it was more of a pleasure to meet some of his boys. So I want to thank Bill and Sue Spence. I want to thank, of course, obviously the Gucciardi family, who almost everybody in here has eaten over their house. Marianne and Richard Gucciardi, thanks so much. It's about people. It's about Ted and Dina Child opening up their home to us for so many alumni afternoons. I'd like to thank so many of you who've been so much an important part of this program. I love what I saw this weekend. This was tremendous. I love what Kevin is doing. I've been sneak, Bob thinks I'm in the office all day long. Sometimes, Bob, I sneak out, I go into the rink, I watch practice, and I see some energy here that I haven't seen in years. Keep it going. Congrats.